Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to band concert with First Hawk Scout and Guide Band. I'd first of all like to introduce our principal guests of honour. This is the Worship Hall, the Mayor of the Royal Borough of Kingston upon Thames, Councillor Brian Bennett. The Worship Hall, the Mayor and Mayoress of the Royal Borough of Windsor and Maidenhead, Councillor and Mrs. Dennis Outwin. I'd also like to welcome somebody who has not been with us before, as the Reverend Mark Durnley, the Vicar of St. Paul's at Hook. His wife was due to be with us, but unfortunately I believe little Charlie's not too well, so we hope he gets better. We also have Mr. John Donaldson, the County Commissioner of Greater London South West, and his wife Margaret. I'd also like to welcome Mr. Bob Bushall, District Commissioner of Surbiton, along with Sue, his wife. We're also pleased to have Mrs. Pam Thomas, who's the District Commissioner of Hook and Chessington Guides, with her husband Paul. And last but not least, I'd like to welcome Mr. Dave Higgs, his ADC Scout for South East Barks, also with his wife Stephanie. Without more ado, then shall we play Imperial Echoes? No, I've got that wrong, you see. You thought I'd do it right. As I say, I'm not doing jokes, and I'll take these off because I can't see them. We have a presentation. Mind don't fall over. We're starting as we mean to go on. Take two. Band Imperial Echo. Thank you. some news here which I think probably everyone will be interested to hear. The lottery. There was 22 million in the total prize fund. The jackpot is 6,900,000. And the numbers are 30, 3, 5, 44, 14, and 22. I wish. Yeah. They are the actual numbers, though. They are the ones that have been drawn tonight. Okay, the next thing now is we've got a couple of awards. You may remember we did this last year. We split them out to stop it getting too boring. And the first award is for the Endeavour Award. And I'll hand over to Dave Thompson, our band master.
Okay, thank you. For a lot of the awards this evening, Jack Wilson will also be coming up, but not for this one. And before we actually start on the awards themselves, I think we should stress that in recognising the achievements of the few that actually get awards this evening, we're not in any way saying that the contribution made by the other band members is not significant. It most definitely is, and it's just that the winners this evening happen to be the best of a very good bunch. Right, and so on to the first award then, which is the Endeavour Award. There are no clear guidelines or rules deliberately for the presentation of this award. We wanted always to be able to have something that we could give to somebody just because, for some reason, and not always one that we could put our finger on, they actually made a positive contribution in some shape or form. This band member is best described as quietly determined, with the emphasis on quiet. Oh, how I wish others were. His attendance record is good and his personal deportment is very impressive. Coupled with his ever-improving ability, his overall performance fully justifies the award. This year's Endeavour Award goes to James Birch.
Movement, go to an event.
burnout and deportment. David.
It's Jackie joined us as well, please, Jack. Before we start on the main set of awards, could I please ask all the current holders of the Jack Wilson sashes to come and hand them back to Jack, please, now. You'll remember that about 2 years ago, Jack gave to the band these green and red sashes so that they could accompany the awards as a visible reminder throughout the year of those that had been recognised as being the best of their sessions. So the turnout deportment, it's only right and fitting that the people that actually have the primary responsibility for deciding upon the recipient of this award are the band, the band's quartermasters, because the trophy was presented to the band in memory of Doug Mew, who for many years was a stalwart on the quartermaster in front. They've had their deliberations, they've looked at the attendance book, and two names have emerged. We have no problem with sharing the awards, it's a big band. It's only right and proper that those who do deserve it are not split simply because there happens to be two of them. Both this year's winners have excellent attendance records, continually impress all the leaders with their smartness on every occasion, and continue to set an example to the rest of the band. This year's winners of the Turnout Award and the W Award are Paul McLean and Joe Urich.
So, we continue. The next piece of music is Minuet in G. Which, it's got tis bells, isn't it?
Yes,
down there. I'll carry on with the Pipe Major, Sam Scott, featuring the drums. like to introduce two people who might have seen before here. I would introduce them if I had their names, but I've lost them. No, I haven't. There's Pipe Major David Clark and Piper John Sinclair. They'd like to come in. We hope they're there. Just briefly, these two gentlemen, they're going to join us on the next piece of music. They belong to the Oatland Park Pipe Band. And the Oatland Park Pipe Band was formed in the coronation year, and as a consequence wears the Royal Stuart tartan. The band has performed at many and various functions throughout its life, and has recently returned from France, where it performed in Paris. Its current strength is 10 pipers and 7 drummers, and is looking forward to another year of engagements, including a proposed visit to Belgium. After the next tune, which of course is Amazing Grace, if anyone guessed that, are you ready? We now have some more awards, starting with the junior bandsman and then the drum awards. David.
Personal terms of deportment as well as music is a vital ingredient in deciding where this award goes each year. We have got a very busy, a large and a very hard working junior band, and as it should always be, it was never easy deciding where it should go. In the past we've shared it, and in the past we've given it to just one person. This year we're going to break with all that and we're going to give it to three people. But it's not going to be quite as cumbersome as you'd have thought. Every 3 months it goes to a different house or something, because two of them actually live in the same house. This year's award goes to Natalie and Rachel Jones and Stacey Adams. award is the Drummer of the Year award. Not wishing to be disrespectful at all, but this year's recipient is a bit of a late developer. It's not often that we recruit directly into the band from the bench unit. Occasionally we do, and this recipient has done just that. You'll see him later playing the triangle. Exceptionally good at it, believe me. He only joined us effectively in April. The first time I met him was at this year's KYBC, when out of the shadows he emerged and started dusting uniforms with bits of sellotape and everything else. He joined immediately after the competition, and he has worked extremely hard. He is up here before the drum instructor on Mondays. He gets all the drums out, he's up there, beating away on his own, and he continues when the leaders are on. A very well-deserved Drummer of the Year, the Arthur Bolt Award, goes to Adam Taylor. Talking of drum instructors, we have been blessed in the past with the quality of our drum instructors, but recently we've had to say goodbye to somebody who's only been with us, in fact, a relatively short period of time, but what an impression he's made. He has now, after I don't know how many years, actually taught a number of us, not certainly not me, a number of the other leaders, how to understand how to read drum music, which I think is a first-rate achievement. Quinton, we're sorry the Lord Mark has moved you, all right, but we've had a little whip, and we've, thank you. Yes, indeed. The drum section would like me to present to you just a small token of their thanks and appreciation, so if you'd like to join me. Because it seems to be an awful long time ago standing up here. I've got one more. About a year ago, I received a letter from Scout Headquarters asking whether we'd be prepared to send along a drum corps to the Windsor Castle St George's Day Parade. Naturally, a little disappointed they didn't invite the whole band, but obviously, we don't want to spoil their day, so yes, of course, we sent along our drum corps. The rest of the group and the rest of the band played as normal for the Southern District St George's Day Parade. And so I asked Jed to take Sam, Chris, Sarah and Scott to Windsor Castle to represent the group and to help them because their other band might be big enough or something, but there we are. The Scout Association had some official photographers there. We've had the proofs, we've ordered copies, and Jed would very much like me to present to the people that represented the band a picture, a photograph, as a member. No, no, thank you. On the day, so please. We've dragged two of them back from university. So if those who went, please come up. I have your photographs here.
being your band. We'll be with you shortly, don't worry. We're going to be playing actually two pieces of music. That's A Bridge Too Far, and they will then carry on with Our Director. We will, the senior band will just give them a little help, of course, but I think you're going to enjoy this. Thank you. have the bells again, along with a solo drummer. Quick now. And they're going to play Dixie. Ladies, the next piece of music will be the last before the interval. But before we do that, I'm going to hand over to David again for the Percussionist Award.
In the past year, this year's Percussionist of the Year has changed instruments, and in doing so, has assumed one of the most important roles within the band. He works hard, remains cheerful, and is one of the most dependable band members we have. This is Percussionist of the Year, and recipient of the Jack Wilson Sash is Kieran von Arbeidsummer.
Okay, as I mentioned, this is going to be the last music before the interval. This, in actual fact, will be its first live performance. Okay, Ray, Old Comrades.
Thank you.
Saturday. That's in the evening from 5 till 8 o'clock, don't forget. There is
Thank you.
thought he said, please, Neil Jack, but he's low enough already.
Neil that show, do you? Right. Okay, the Woodwind Award, first of all, then, this year it's shared between two of the longest serving members of the section. They both joined the band as guides before moving onto the bench unit. One of the award winners can usually be heard above the band, and through her abilities made the Buko, which is a tune you'll hear, I think, when he's joined the programme, possible as a piece of music for us. Second winner still retains our link with the Quebec Tambour Corps by being the remaining fife player of the band. This year's Woodwind Award goes to Claire Steele and Julie Shortland. And so on to the trumpeter or brass player of the year. Although recently work has created difficulties for this year's winner making every rehearsal, his input and effort over the last 12 months remains impressive. He has fully mastered his new instrument, and throughout everything he maintains that oh-so-ever vital element of humour. This year's trumpeter of the year, recipient of a Jack Wilson sash, is our very own Private Tucker, Daniel Rogers. Now another presentation by us, but not to one of the members of the band this time. I mentioned earlier how vital the leaders are for the band. You've given a small presentation to one who's recently left us, and now it's time to give a very special presentation to a very special leader. David Newman has now, after a good many years with us, decided that he needs to have a rest. I can understand that his energy levels couldn't be maintained as he maintained them for us. David, we are extremely grateful to you for everything you've done for us over the years. My only regret is that we couldn't actually get tonight what we had hoped to present you with. The manufacturers actually tell us they don't make it anymore. We've got what we think is the next best thing, but even then it'll take another 4 weeks before we can get our grubby little hands on it. I've got here a pewter soldier, Dave, of my dad's that we're going to give to you tonight, simply as a, if you like, a bargaining point. You'll give that back to us when we get the real thing. We had hoped for an ordinary pewter bugler, but we couldn't get that. We've now got you a solid pewter light infantryman bugler, so that whenever you look at it, you can think of Kilro and have a good laugh at us. All right, so David Newman, if you would like to come up and just accept it.
Thank you.
done recently. Don't understand it, because I tied the rope myself. Well, I got a reaction at that. Now, David mentioned this one next. Again, another favourite, Nabucco. Now for band bandsman and runner-up band.
The band bandsman award is the one that the band awards to one of their own. They put it to a vote, and in the past we have had Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck appearing, but funnily enough, not this year. This year's winner won by a significant margin, which often is not actually the case. Popular with the leaders as well as clearly with his peers. This year's band's bandsman of the year is Kieran Boone. Now the runner-up bandsman of the year. A bit of a coup this year, as this man picks up his third award. He has clearly made a huge impression, not only on the leaders, but with everybody associated with the band. He shows maturity beyond his years. This year's runner-up bandsman of the year and recipient of the Whitehead Award is Kieran Long. Thank you. presentation by Helen Brown at this year's Brown Bursary. As many of you will know, Helen very kindly set up this bursary in memory of Les, and each year she very kindly, from the proceeds of that, makes a small donation to the band. We restocked our white gloves, and last year we started restocking on these white drag ropes for the drums. This year we now complete that, Helen, with our very grateful thanks. So if you'd like to come up and present these now to Chris. This last year has again been one of great success. For the first time in this group's history, first have composed a band that has been recognised as the National Marching Band Champions of the Scout Association. This is no mere achievement and requires a great deal of dedication and hard work from the band members and from the leaders. In addition to the band, the training sections to which every member must also belong offer some of the busiest itineraries you can find in any scout group. We're also acutely aware of the continuing support the group executive, who, touch wood, have yet to turn down any spending the rest I have made. The most visible items purchased recently have of course been the gigawls, which following last year's unfortunate incidences at the Windsor Remembrance Parade, proved to be absolutely invaluable last weekend, both for the Remembrance Parade and the Lord Mayor's Show. Looking out to the future, we will of course continue to strive for improvement whilst ensuring that we offer a place within the band, not only for youngsters with ability, but those with simply commitment. We hope to raise the quality of our public engagements to match the quality of the band, and there of course still remains that exclusive, yet rather elusive, Queen Scout Parade at Windsor Castle. We can but little hope. Next year also sees a return trip to Denmark, and just to plug here, I haven't had forms or money back from quite a lot of you, so please, we are very close to losing the ferry booking, so let me have them within a week. Thank you. We've witnessed tonight the au revoir of the two leaders. In the last year, we've also had to say the same to a number of senior band members. Yet at the same time, our ranks have been swelled by youngsters moving in junior band. Such changes are of course natural, and it is a particular encouragement to see the younger leaders becoming more hungry for additional responsibilities. With their help, the future is indeed bright.
The next piece of music is one which will probably stay in the minds of a lot of band members. It's called
Blaze Away!
Thank you.
words. Thank you, Margaret. That normally wasn't it.
Just a few very important words. We've seen a lot of uniforms here tonight, and as chairman, as most of you know, I do stand here as representative of all of you who don't wear uniforms. And from that point of view, I would like to say a personal thank you to all the parents, the friends, the girlfriends and the wives, everyone who gives their support to these young people and to the leaders and backroom people within the band. They do a wonderful job. They can't congratulate themselves, and I think probably I'm the only one who can really do that on your behalf. So I do offer my sincere congratulations to the personnel behind this wonderful band of ours. Thank you very much indeed. Which David touched on, that is the role of the Executive Committee. This is just to publicly endorse that we shall, of course, endeavour to continue to give you our support and to maintain the band and its equipment as far as we are able. So we look forward to many years of hearing this wonderful sound. Two commercials, don't forget the fair, and I've got a lot of web ivory books if anybody would like to get them from me afterwards. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
While we wait for the fighters to come in, too soon, Margaret, reminds me, have you noticed that children these days are becoming bilingual? You know, at school they speak English, quite good, but then they rush home through the doors and say, Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia! Thank you, Quentin, someone appreciates me. Okay, now as you've noticed, we have our fighters with us again, and we're going to play Highland Cathedral.
Thank you.
And there will be a little bear camera by the door if, as you pass out, please, thank you. I mean, that's passed through. No one's passing out. Not yet. Well, we have the main award of the evening. It's the band. I don't know, it's fixed down to fun, but it's the Bandsman of the Year award.
This year's Band Member of the Year is one of the best jumpers this band has ever produced. About a year ago, she had to move away, oddly enough, into the Royal Borough of Windsor. Consequently, her attendance became less regular, and this meant she stood out of the competition, but remained in the band. The week before KYBC, another trumpeter very thoughtfully decided to have his attendance taken out, without even allowing a lift. A quick phone call from me to the studio newsroom, and she was back in the routine with literally about 3 days' notice. 1 hour's rehearsal on the morning of the competition, and dare I say to the untrained eye, she gave a faultless performance. Not only that, but she also won the solo of the day trophy. Despite the distance between Hook and Windsor, she remains as regular as she can be, loyal, well turned out, and totally dependable. This year's Band Member of the Year, recipient of the Jack Wilson Sash and the Baron Saxo Trophy, is not here tonight.
No.
She really, really could not make it. The winner is Michelle Bourne, and to receive the award in her stead is Peter Noakes. Just before this young man here goes to sit down, would you actually believe that he's 70 today?
Who told you that?
I mean, it's true, isn't it, Jack? It is, isn't it? Can you believe he's actually 70 today?
Can you believe that this Jack used to be smaller than me once? Thank you.
By instructions, you think. This certificate is given to record the very excellent standard of play and marching by the First Hook Scout and Guide Band, presented by me this evening. the message on the arms alone. And the message said, "Would I ring Beatley House, that's Scout headquarters, and speak to Peter Byrne?" So I rang back, and this Peter Byrne said to me, "Oh, County Commissioner, can I have your permission?" Now that's unusual, because not many people ask my permission. They usually get on and do it. And I said, "You didn't have my permission, what for?" He said, "I would like to invite the First Hook Scout and Guide Band to play at the National St George's Day at Windsor next year." One other comment on tonight, the trumpet was presented by Delbert.
right group operation that allows the young people to do it, to do the band, and I thank all the scouts of the group for allowing the band to reach the standard it has, and in particular the band leaders for their extra efforts. Thank you very much indeed.
We'll march, Neil Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding for sunset?